Hello everyone, and welcome to something that's gonna be a little different. I was at a half price today, and I found this demo disc, and it happened to have Halo, and well, me being a big fan of Halo, I couldn't help but resist, but yeah. It also helps I got an original Xbox yesterday. Cool. Back when you had to download demos, or stuff off the disc. Music, videos. Oh yeah, and I want to watch these later, but they have like Halo Seats 1, Halo Seats 2, from G4. Funny enough, that website's still up, it's just not updated anymore. But let's go to the main meat of it. The demos. We have Halo, that's what we're gonna play. We have Madden NFL 2003, Madden NFL Fever 2003, Panzer Dragoon? Oh. Quantum Redshift, Splinter Cell, Time Splitters 2, Codejam and Earl 3, gross, sounds like a gross name, and Whacked. But let's get over to the, I've only played it a little bit, I don't know what all's gonna be different, I don't imagine much is, but, alright, never mind, there it is. Alright, but welcome to Halo on the original Xbox, and I am using the original controller, the good old Duke. I really like this one. I was happy to find it. $15, I'd say that's a fair deal, but also I already have these two, but I got Metal Gear Solid 2 Substance and Splinter Cell Chaos Theory. The reason I got those are because, again, is because they have the box art and manuals. Which, mines don't have that.
The Covenant believe that what they call the Silent Cartographer is somewhere under this island. The Cartographer is a map room that will lead us to Halo's control center. The island has multiple structures and installations. One of them contains the map room.
We're approaching the LZ. It's gonna be hot. Get set to cut out quick. Touchdown, Teddy Marines!
Oh yeah, so that's the controller I have, the big ol' one. Let's go. Yeah, I'm still getting used to this controller. I'm not used to the buttons being angled up this much. Trigger pull is actually a little more resistant. Let me see. So I can't enable subtitles, so nothing. Only thing I can do is invert the aiming if I wanted to do that. I wonder if this is the same demo where whenever I first went to GameStop, someone drove the Warthog all the way out into the ocean and I had no idea what to do, so I couldn't really properly play the game. Me being a terrible driver. Nothing new.
Take that.
Oh, I was scratching my eye. Fuck. There we go.
Hey,
Yes, we're just gonna bypass the whole door part and just gonna go up here and skip it. Oh yeah, since I got the Xbox, I've gotten some more games. I didn't have any plans to get this, but it was only $3. I got the original. Oh, not original, but I got 007 Everything or Nothing. I looked up reviews and it seemed to be pretty well received. I think I played the demo of it back in the day as a kid. I don't remember much of it. I'm also trying to find component cables for this system. Although it seems like they're $50 to $60 off eBay and Amazon, so it seems like I'm gonna have to, if I hope to find it for a cheaper price, I'm gonna have to get lucky. Wonder why they thought making that enemy susceptible to one shot was the pistol was a smart choice. Oh yeah, you get no choice of difficulty, as you saw. It's either, if I had to guess, it's probably on normal. What the hell? What's up with the health? Or the, what is that? Or to the left. Oh wait, that's the heat meter, never mind. Sorry, it's been a while since I played Halo 1. God, I forgot that was up there. Ah, damn. Not my bright, smartest choice. Forgot to save my pistol bullets. There we go, you're dead. Wow, even the buttons are the angled ones. Located somewhere else on this island. Shut the system down so the Covenant won't be able to lock us out. We should now have access to the main facility. Let's find the map.
Mayday, mayday, drop ship.
Damn, I have like no ammo.
Repeat, we are under heavy fire and are
Thank you. Just what I needed.
Bravo 22 was bringing us some heavy weapons. After I saw we were up against hunters, I thought you could use them. Let's move down the beach. Keep an eye out for any cargo we can salvage.
There we go. Pretty cool. I never realized that. Then again, I haven't played this version in ages. Previous car? Yeah, they're still alive. Sweet. And they're in good health. Good. I have no idea how much of this demo there is. I only played like the first five or like the first minute of it just to check it out. Making noise? Did they always make noises? I guess they did. I don't know. Half the time when I play games, I'm zoned out. Just focused on it.
The Covenant are putting up a real fight. The cartographer must be here. My analysis indicates that the map room should be at the bottom floor of this facility.
I love you too much, assault rifle.
Let's keep going inside.
All right, let's see if I can fix the picture real quick. For some reason, the right side. But yeah, I don't know why the picture isn't. Wait, even on my monitor is not there. Huh, I didn't notice that. I plan on buying Halo for the Xbox, just they had two versions, but two copies, but unfortunately they were the greatest hits one, and I really want to get the original. satisfying. Just whip out a rocket launcher and shoot them in the face.
If we don't get out of here before additional reinforcements.
Oh god, I'm confused.
Let's find that map.
That should be the door over there. Yep. You're lucky.
There. That hollow panel should activate the map. Analyzing. Halo's control center is located there. That structure appears to be some sort of temple or shrine, if I've interpreted this correctly.
You know what? Alright, so I will watch the seat videos of Halo, and if they get claimed, I'll just edit them out. Simple as that.
The captain has dropped out of contact, Cortana. His ship may be out of range or having equipment problems.
Keep trying. Let me know when you've re-established contact, and then tell him that the Master Chief and I have determined the location of the control center. We'll be heading there as soon as we're topside.
Affirmative. Full hammer out.
I'm not used to using the B button to melee. I typically play Halo with the Recon, since I have an Elite controller. Let's see if we can get past this back here. Or just throw a grenade, kill all of y'all. I guess $50 will probably be the best deal I can get. And this is really dark though. think I encounter more hunters. It was the other side. My bad. Land that stinky grenade. I can't remember if the original Xbox frame rate is like this, or if it's because it's the demo. I won't know until I get the game and replay it. Damn it. Thought it was a little further back. What the hell? I almost died. All right, looks like that should be the end of it.
In the full version of Halo, you'll find additional vehicles like tanks, plasma turrets, and aircraft. Powerful new human and alien weapons. A single-player campaign spanning 10 massive indoor and outdoor environments. And support for intense multiplayer battles with up to 16 of your friends.
Or enemies.
All that wrapped up in an epic sci-fi story that's so freaky. Whoa! It makes me shake just thinking about it. Halo, Combat Evolved. Buy one! Heck, buy two!
That's an order, soldier!
Man, I miss demos. Alright, well, that was the demo. So thank you all for watching. Y'all have a good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and good night. Now we're gonna continue on to the G4. And if this gets copyrighted, we'll edit it out.
If you played Halo for the Xbox, you know how realistic this first-person shooter plays. For little lizard aliens, those Covenant enemies are smart enough to dodge, hide, and snipe you like pros. Even the vehicles in the game feature realistic physics, which is where the fun starts. Ever notice how the game's Jeep called the Warthog reacts to rocks, hills, and explosions? Well, we're about to show you how to have some fun with some explosives and an expensive piece of military machinery. Get ready to do your very own Warthog jump from the safety of your couch.
Halo quickly became the Uber game to play in the new Xbox system. Its intense action, movie-styled storyline, intense visuals, and realistic physics made for some incredible gameplay. Those physics in the game have given gamers a secret, which the game designers may or may not have known would happen. This phenomenon is what has been named the Warthog Jump. It will go down in the annals of video game history as being created by a Halo gamer named Randall Glass. Randall's Warthog Jump, a Halo physics experiment, has achieved its own 15 minutes of fame as a highly downloaded internet clip. You may be wondering how to create your own Warthog Jump. The idea is simple, but a bit time-consuming. The effect, though, is amazing, and oftentimes quite hilarious. Start by going to level 4, the Silent Cartographer. The downside to doing this is you have to take out several of your own teammates. When you do, they will often drop grenades. The trick is to keep these grenades close to each other when they drop them. After you have a group of grenades on the ground, you need to get a Warthog. The Warthog is the way cool military Jeep you tool around in on this level. Park the Warthog over the grenades. All you have to do is set off a chain reaction from the drop grenades and... yes, you too can send your Warthog into orbit. If you get really good at this, you might even be able to replicate Randall's launching of a Warthog over this nearby mountain. We even managed to get one to land on top of our soldier. Randall's hang time record is 8.5 seconds. We made it to nearly 8 with this jump. If you land an extra, well-placed grenade inside the Warthog, this will somewhat extend the jump. You might be wondering how to get on top of the mountain arch. Head up this path where you find a pair of hunters. You will need to park a Warthog on this rock, and you should be able to jump up to the top of the arch. From here, you can get a great view of your airborne Warthog.
Ah, never knew that was a thing. I only remember seat with a female actress. All right, let's look at the second one.
If you want to be known around your block as a Halo master, then you're going to have to beat the game on the hardest level of difficulty, Legendary. Like the name says, you're going to have to play like a champion if you're going to get through the game in this mode. But we've got some tips on this difficult level that even a Master Chief could use.
Xbox gamers who have played Halo know that the game isn't easy, even when it's set on easy. Of the four levels in the game, the hardest by far is Legendary. This difficulty setting is bound to give even the most battle-hardened space combat veterans a tough bit of gaming.
We're coming in too fast!
We may have discovered a secret of sorts to getting through one of the early choke points in the Legendary level. It may seem a bit cowardly, especially considering the in-your-face action of this game, whose tagline is Combat Evolved. But if it gets you one step closer to victory against the Covenant, then it's okay with us.
Warning. I've detected multiple Covenant dropships on approach.
On the second level, when you and the survivors of the Pillar of Autumn have crash-landed on Halo, you are faced with an overwhelming horde of Covenant troops. Now, you can do what any Master Chief worthy of his MA5B rifle would do to those slimy aliens, and probably get yourself filled with alien weapons discharge. Or you could try this new cheat tactic and save some ammo and quite possibly some frustration, on this level at least.
Alert, Covenant dropship inbound. They must be looking for survivors. I recommend immediate evasion.
Thank you, Cortana. We're going to do just that. Duck inside this bunker and just hang out. You'll hear the sounds of grunting aliens outside, but don't be tempted to peek out and engage them. The trick here is in the music cues. You should be hearing this level's familiar battle hymn. The music swells as it reaches a crescendo before recycling and starting over. This is what to listen for. After you hear the crescendo a third time, you should hear the cavalry arrive.
This is Pelican Echo
Fire Team Charlie.
Now you can leave the bunker to find Foehammer dropping off a Warthog for you. Don't worry if you see red enemy blips on your motion tracker. Once the dropship sequence begins, you are safe to leave the bunker and make for the Warthog.
The cavalry has arrived! Good to see you, sir.
It's a mess, sir. We're scattered all over this battle.
Now, this only helps you at the beginning of this level, but since you are fighting alone until your Warthog arrives and you round up some of your fellow Marines, you might want to hang back and let this newly discovered secret play to your advantage. Don't worry, soldier. There'll be enough Covenant aliens to take on in this same level.
All right. Well, that covers everything. Well, that covers the Halo 1 stuff. Let's just take a look at this, see what this is about. Oh shit. That was cool. Well, thank you all for watching. That's pretty cool to take a blast in the past. Alright, but y'all take care, and hopefully I won't have to edit out too much if copyrights become an issue, but later, thanks for watching. You were mine.